Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC695ALG616. This is a 16-channel single-ended voltage or current DC. Voltage is good for negative 10 to positive 10 volts DC, and current is measured in milliamps DC, 0 to 20 milliamps. Okay, so I'm gonna go through and show you guys how to test this and how to troubleshoot it. First thing is, if you notice, I have it in the rack that's powered up, and I have a blinking green module OK light. That's a good thing to see. If you don't have any light on there, or if it's red, then that means that there's something wrong with the card. It would need replacement or repair. And it also means you wouldn't be able to follow this test. But if you have some sort of a system that's powered up the way you see it here in my rack, and it looks like this, that's a good start. So the first thing is, you'll notice that I have a terminal strip that, I'm going to pull this off to show you guys better, that I have jumpers going down the right hand side. That's from terminal screw number 19 to number 36, with the exception of number 28, which I don't have it jumpered between 28 and 27. All right, otherwise the whole thing's jumpered. Now this is a high density terminal. I'm going to place it on the module itself. You'll notice that my terminal block LED is red. That means that the lever is not in the most upright position, which attaches it completely to make connection to the module. So we're going to do that. I'm going to slide this up. Now my field status and my terminal block lights are both green. That means it's connected and it sees it. All right. Now that that's connected, the two devices I'm going to be using for this test, just to show you guys, and I'll explain more later, is for my voltage end, I'm going to use a 3-volt DC battery with a positive and negative lead attached to it to probe each channel. And then the other thing I'm going to use is, that you're unable to see, is a 4 to 20 milliamp output generator with adjustable range. It's 4 to 20 milliamps DC. That's important. And and I'll get into why the range and resolution is a very important thing to test in just a moment. So, next thing we're going to do is get into the software end of it. Well, I'm using Proficy Machine Edition, and I have an open blank file here. Now, the first thing I want to do is go to Navigator, expand on my rack. I'm using a CHS007. You can use a CHS012 or 016 to follow this test. It won't make any difference. My power supply, or your power supply, is going to be using slots 0 and 1. That uses two slots. And the CPU, I'm using an IC695 CPU 320, is using slots 2 and 3. All right, that's important to note, because the next available slot that you're going to be able to use is slot number 4. All right, I'm going to right-click on that, or double-click Add Module, where we have an Analog Input tab. And we'll go down to IC695ALG616. As I described before, it's a 16-channel input voltage or current. Hit OK. All right, now there's going to be, you're going to need to do a little bit of adjustments here and make some edit some of these values. First thing that you want to notice is that the channel reference value, where the location and where we're going to be reading these values, is going to be percent analog input 00001. Okay. Currently, it's in single-ended input mode. That's good. Starting with channel number 1, the channel is currently disabled. All right. So now we're going to select that we want to turn it on by hitting voltage current, and the first range it's going to give us is the default range is negative 10 to positive 10 volts DC. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and go with that. We're going to use the 10 volt DC, but the channel format we're going to change. This is the scaling, you'll notice, change to a 16-bit integer. And now we have a similar looking, this negative 10 to positive 10 as values of 10,000 maximum or negative 10,000 minimum. All right. And we're going to go ahead with every channel and do that. We're going to enable the circuit. 10 volts DC, that's good. 16-bit integer. Enable, 16-bit integer. Enable, 16-bit integer. Now I'm just going to go through you know, a half a dozen channels of doing this, and then we'll go ahead and start a test. Okay, so I got the first six channels. I recommend that you do all 16 channels, but this is just for example. Once I've done that, I'm going to select the online offline, click on that lightning bolt icon, connect up to the processor. Once we're connected to the processor, we're going to hit the green handprint to toggle us online. And what that means is, if you follow my arrow down below, this is a status bar, and it tells us we're in programmer mode. The run feature is stopped, faulted, and the configuration is not equal. The reason that it's faulted is because, and this just should be about the what yours reads at, it might say stop disabled and it might say configuration logic or not equal. Either way, it's telling you that the processor was handling a different task before you asked it to test this ALG616. So what we're going to do is go to target, online commands, clear, and we're going to clear the fault tables, the IO fault table and controller fault table. Okay, those are the only two selections you need to worry about. Then we're going to hit download and start active target icon here. When it asks us what we want to download to the controller, it's just going to be hardware configuration and motion and logic. Okay, these are the top two selections. Hit OK. Now, going back to the fault tables we cleared, that's really important that you clear those fault tables. As I said before, the processor and the software are going to know that you're asking it to do something different and that it's going to be faulted. And if you don't clear those, then you're going to get hung up during this download process, and it's going to slow things way down for you. All right, so make sure that you do that. Another thing is this is just a simple test. We're just going to be simply probing these terminals, these channels, to make sure that they're working. So there's no need to write anything to permanent flash memory or anything like that. All right, we'll keep it as simple as possible. Now, it takes about a minute to download. Once there, here we go. We want to enable the outputs, and we should be, again, look at your bar down below, programmer mode. The run is enabled, IO is enabled. Configuration and logic are equal. It should read like that. If for some reason it doesn't, or if you're still stopped, or if it's faulted, go to your feedback zone and find out why. This is my feedback zone located here, and it'll give you information. And if it's not in run mode, you could also simply open up the processor's battery door, the reserve battery door, and make sure that your input-output lever is in the far right position. It's a switch that goes from left to right. It should be in the far right position to enable the outputs. Okay. Once you're in the same position I'm in here, we're going to drag this bar down to the navigator, go to default tables, expand on that, and analog input. Okay, now, as I mentioned before, if you look in your settings in the ALG616, we're going to begin on analog input 00001. That is found in the upper right hand corner. As you can see, I'm hovering my arrow above it, and it's telling me in this illuminated percent analog input 00001. So if you go by the diagram on the inside of the door, you'll notice that the common terminal is number 5, and that the first four channels are screws on the left hand side, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then it's descending after that. Terminal 6 is channel 5, terminal 7 is number 6, and so on. And we're probing in a vertical pattern, meaning that the channels are all up and down rather than left and right. So just keep that in mind. Now I'm going to plant my negative lead on number 5 and my positive lead on number 1. And immediately I have a value of, depending on what your scaling is, 2145. Probe number 2, approximately the same value, it's stable. Number 3, okay, number 4, and I can keep going all the way down. Just make sure that your negative lead is planted on one of the commons, The commons, or where the negative lead goes, is terminal number 5 and terminal number 14. Okay, all the rest of the terminals on the left-hand side are voltage input channels. Okay, so that's how to test voltage. A couple quick things about that. I mentioned I use a 3-volt battery. I find that the 3-volt battery is helpful because it puts me in the lower middle of the range of the maximum 10 volts. You know, it's about a third of the way through the range. It is stable because it's coming out of a battery. It's the value should be stable. It shouldn't be going up and down, you know, like a full volt or a half a volt back and forth at a time. So make sure that it's stable, that it's active, and also make sure that when you probe it, if you're using a 3-volt battery, that it's giving you a pretty much an accurate reading. Sometimes when these analog input cards fail, they fail at full value. So you'll probe it with the 3 volts or 2 volts or something like that, or even 1.5, and it'll continue to tell you that you're using 10 volts when that isn't the case, okay? That's immediately a failed circuit. Sometimes they fail, again, at full value, as if the value is at its max. You can also use a 10 volt power supply that's variable from 0 to 10 volts. If for some reason you want to check it in a negative 10 volts, going from negative 10 volts all the way to 0 volts or positive 10, you could simply change your leads so that your positive probe is your common and your negative probe is now the lead that you would touch to each channel. All right. Now that we've tested voltage, I'm going to stop the controller, go back to our tab, slot number 4, ALG616, channel 1, and I'm going to just simply switch it to 4 to 20 milliamp. You can use 0 to 20 milliamp if that's something that you need or something that you have. I happen to have a 4 to 20 milliamp generator, so that's what I'm going to use. And again, I'm just going to do the first 6 channels, so just as an example. Now, pay attention down below. What's the status we're in? We're stopped, we're disabled, our configuration is not equal anymore. Again, this is just a slight difference. We're just asking it to check milliamp, but it can see the difference. It knows that it's different, and it's going to fault you. Go to online commands through the target bar, clear, and we want to clear controller and I/O fault table. Okay. Yes. Again, make sure you do that, or you're going to get hung up when we do the download and start active target, which we're doing now. Same thing as before. When it asks us what do we want to download to the controller, just hardware configuration and motion and logic. We'll keep it really simple as possible. You're just probing the inputs to make sure that the card works. Okay. Top 2 selections, yes. Okay, while this is downloading, I'm going to mention the same thing I mentioned before. I'm using a 4 to 20 milliamp DC output generator. What I like about this particular generator, you guys aren't able to see it, but it has range and resolution. I have a dial on here that allows me to dial literally all the way down to 4 milliamps, then all the way up to 20 milliamps or thereabouts. And the reason that's important is because the card is made to read a very fine range and resolution of current in milliamps DC. All right, that's an important feature, and you got to make sure that feature is working. So, same thing as the voltage DC, these cards will fail or can fail at full value, telling you that no matter what value you probe it with, it may be reporting that it's receiving 20 milliamps when it may not be true at all. Okay, so it's good to check your range and resolution. And we're going to say OK and turn on our outputs. Everything is equal, run mode. Again, if you're not in run mode, check the reasons why, check your feedback zone, check that your controller's position of the switch is in the right position. We're going to start in the top right hand corner like we did before, analog input 00001. Now, if you notice on the wiring diagram, instead of probing these channels vertically like we did with DC, we're probing them horizontally, and they're jumpered. I showed you the jumpers before, going down the right-hand side of the terminal strip. our negative lead will go on the side of the terminal strip that's jumpered, that's the right hand side, and our positive lead will be on the left hand side. So our first channel begins on 1 and 19, very top two screws. And we have a positive value of nearly 20 milliamps. Okay. Now I'm going to take the button, the switch that I have that allows me to dial down. You can see my value changing down, down, down. You know, we're at about 12, nearly 12 and a half milliamps. I'm going to take these probes off and go to my channel 2. Positive on 2, negative on 20. And I'm going to continue to dial up and down the values. I'm having a tough time keeping these leads on. I apologize for that. Number 3. I'm going to dial down. And then back up. Okay. A firm connection is really important. As you can see, I'm kind of pushing these probes into these terminals. Another thing that you might want to do is screw down the terminals. I noticed that if the terminal, the screw itself is loose, you get a poor reading. So make sure that those are down in their lowest position or their tightest position. And as you can see, I'm dialing the value down and up. And so on. Now, if I was testing this card in our lab from a customer, then I would test all 16 channels the exact same way. I would check the full range and resolution, and I would look for all the problems I mentioned before. So, as a quick recap, from the beginning, when you plug the module in to the rack, you should have a blinking module OK light on. When the terminal strip is completely fastened to the module with the lever in the upright position, your field status and your terminal block LEDs should both be on in green. When you're probing each channel, whether you're using voltage DC or milliamps DC, depending on your needs, you need to make sure that you have first a working circuit, a working channel, 2, that the channel is stable, and 3, that the channel is not immediately giving you full value when you may not be actually giving it a full value of 10 volt or a full value of 20 milliamps. Keep in mind that they do tend to or occasionally fail at full value. That's a problem. Now, ALG616 is a module that we very commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs and new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.